Hello and welcome. In this video series, we're going to cover some fundamental AWS tagging concepts using Terraform. My name is Derek Morgan, and I'm a DevOps and Infrastructure as Code course creator at morethancertified.com, and I'm here courtesy of my friends at cloudforecast.io to help you get your AWS resources tagged properly and efficiently with Terraform. So, let's get started. In the first video of this series, we're going to cover basic resource level and deployment level tagging. First up, let's provide the AWS provider. We'll then add a random resource and then an S3 bucket. So let's go ahead and start that. Now, if you check over here in the docs, we've got this nice little template for our provider here. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy all of this. Then I'm going to create a main.tf, just like so, open that up and paste that in. Now the current provider version is actually 4.0, so I'm going to change that and we won't be using any of the breaking changes that came about in this version. And then I'm just going to change my region to US West 2, as that's one I just like to use. All right, so now that we've got our provider set up and we're able to access the AWS API, I am in the Cloud 9 console, which actually has default access to the API. If you're in VS Code or some other IDE on your own computer, you'll need to add those credentials yourself. So now let's go ahead and add that random ID, which will be used to ensure that our S3 buckets are unique globally. So if you click on the docs, you can see we've got some examples here. I'm just going to manually type this out since they've added so much extra stuff that we don't need. So let's go ahead and add resource, random ID, just like so. We'll just call that S3 ID. Open and close my braces there. And we'll give that a byte length of 2, which should be plenty. So now that we've done that, let's go ahead and create an S3 bucket. So I'm going to say resource AWS S3 bucket, and we'll just call this one the DevOps bucket. And then what I want to do is just specify the bucket name here, and we'll just call that DevOps bucket and random id.s3_id.dec, just like so. And as you can see, we've used those curly braces and the dollar sign for interpolation syntax. So now that I've done that, let's go ahead and add some tags. So we'll just say tags equals, open and close more curly braces there. And we'll provide an environment tag, just env, and we'll just say dev. We're going to give it a service tag, and that is obviously S3. And then we'll give it a team tag of DevOps, just like so. All right, so now we have added our S3 bucket and given it the tags that management requires for all of our deployments. Let's go ahead and deploy this and ensure everything works. So we'll run a Terraform init. Then let's run a Terraform plan. All right, great. Looks like everything is good to go. We've got our tags there. And notice we also have a tags_all attribute. We'll be revisiting that soon. So that looks good. Let's go ahead and run a Terraform apply, auto approve. And let's ensure that that's there. So I'll head to my S3 console, refresh, and there it is, DevOps bucket 14703. All right, perfect. So now let's go ahead and add another bucket. I'm actually going to just copy this and paste it down below. And we'll call this the finance bucket. And then we'll give it another name of finance, just like so. And of course the team is finance. And we'll go ahead and save that. Now let's go ahead and run our Terraform plan once again. All right, everything looks good. It needs to add one bucket, of course. As you can see, the tags are different. We now have a team of finance. So that's perfect. So let's go ahead and apply that. Terraform apply, auto approve, just like so. All right, I'll head to my S3 console, refresh. And as you can see, we now have a finance bucket. Perfect. Okay, so as you can tell, we actually are using the env tag twice here. Now, what if we just want to ensure that that is always specified no matter what? What we can do is head right up here to our provider, and we can add what's called default tags. So we'll just add default tags, just like so. And then we specify a tags block, just like we have in our resources. So tags equals, and from here we can say env equals dev, just like so. Now, one thing to note is that explicitly defined tags will override our default tags. So if we were to delete this tag, we could run a Terraform plan on that. And as you can see here, it still changes the tag, but it's still adding the same exact tag we had, only it's a default tag. So even though it doesn't technically change anything, it's still considered an update in place. So do keep that in mind, but it's not going to remove the tag completely. So if we run a Terraform apply, auto approve, just like so, we can head into our S3 console and refresh. And we'll go ahead and click on the one that we changed, which was the finance bucket. Head to properties. And as you can see, we still have our environment, service, and team tags. So that default tag is a great way to tag a full deployment if everything is going to be the same. So once again, I could also delete this one, run another Terraform apply, auto approve. All right, and we will refresh in our S3 console here. As you can see, everything's here still for our finance bucket, of course. I will head back and check out our DevOps bucket and properties. And once again, all of our tags are there. So the default tag works. And just know that any explicit tags will always override the default tag. So if I were to change this to env equals prod on the finance bucket and Terraform apply, auto approve. As you can see that change right there, we head back in, take a look at our buckets, finance bucket, properties, environment is now prod. All right, so that is a quick overview of basic tagging. Go ahead and end this video and continue on to the next one if you'd like to see some more advanced tagging concepts.